Welcome to Container Orchestration with Docker Swarm Mode. I'm Logan Rakai, and I'll be your instructor for this course. I'm a content researcher and developer here at Cloud Academy. I've been thinking a lot about how to maximize the return on your time invested in this course. I'm confident that you'll be confident in your skills to orchestrate containers with Docker Swarm Mode after completing the course. I have over 10 years of experience in software research and development, including 5 years in the cloud. I'm an AWS Certified DevOps Engineer Professional, and a Microsoft Certified Solutions Expert, Cloud Platform and Infrastructure. You can connect with me on LinkedIn or on Twitter. This course is for anyone that is interested in orchestrating distributed systems at any scale. This includes DevOps engineers, site reliability engineers, cloud engineers, and software engineers. In order to get the most out of this course, you should have experience with Docker. You should have a solid understanding of images, networks, volumes, and have experience using Docker Compose for managing multi-container applications. If you need to brush up on any of these topics, Cloud Academy has some great courses for that. Introduction to Docker covers fundamental Docker concepts and managing applications with Docker Compose by yours truly for working with multi-container applications using Docker Compose. You can follow along with the course examples, and I'd encourage you to. You will need Docker version 1.13 or greater installed. I'll be using a Mac with Docker for Mac version 17.12 installed, but you can also follow along in Linux. Swarm Mode in Windows has some additional limitations, mainly around network encryption. I'll mention the limitations when we cover the relevant topic. Almost everything we discuss will apply to Windows environments, but I'll be using Linux containers in the demos. You should have VirtualBox installed as well. I've put resources that are used for the demos on GitHub. A clickable link is available at the bottom of the transcript for this lesson. Most of the work will happen at the command line, although we will work with some files near the end of the course. I'll be using Visual Studio Code for working with the files, but you could use whatever you are comfortable with. After completing this course, you will be able to describe what Docker Swarm Mode can accomplish, explain the architecture of a Swarm Mode cluster, use the Docker CLI to manage nodes in a Swarm Mode cluster, use the Docker CLI to manage services in a Swarm Mode cluster, and deploy multi-service applications to a swarm using stacks. I'm happy to hear from you. I make content for you, and I want it to be as good as it can be. If you have any feedback, please get in touch with me by leaving a comment on the comments tab below this video, by emailing support@cloudacademy.com, or by connecting with me on Twitter, where my handle is @LoganRakai.